Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. It's Nicolex here, and today we're going to be continuing on with Life is Strange True Colors. Last time I left us on a big cliffhanger, Charlotte just admitted to us that she blames Ethan for Gabe's death. We stole Diane's flash drive, and we set up the LARP for Ethan, and it went pretty well until the sirens reminded Ethan of Gabe's death. Yeah, that's pretty much where we're at. I'm gonna continue on, and when we get back to the point of where it was, I'll see you there. Okay, guys, so back to the point where we were. Didn't have to do too much, so yeah, let's continue on. This is fucking crazy.
I can deal with hating Ryan, or you. Or even Gabe! But Ethan... If he had just listened, Gabe would still be alive. It all comes back to that.
It's not his fault, though. Ugh. Your actions are what matters.
None of that makes you a bad mom. No matter what you're feeling, you always give Ethan what he needs. That's what matters.
None of it fucking matters! He's dead!
I wish I were too.
This anger could kill her. And nothing I'm saying is helping. What if I could just take it away?
What? Can you do that? No fucking way.
I can do it. I can take her anger from her.
That's fucking insane.
What would that do to her? What would it do to me? And even if I can, should I?
Don't make me make a fucking decision on that. God! Fuck! Oh my god, I love this, but I hate it at the same time! Okay, if I leave her alone, I feel like she could hurt Ethan. There's a possibility she could hurt Ethan or herself. However, if I take it, what does that do to me? What does that do to Alex? And I'm no longer putting myself in Alex's spot. I care for Alex as Alex. Ugh, fuck. Alright. Let's do it. We're gonna take her anger. I'm scared as shit though.
Alex?
She's just drained.
I'm okay. Are you okay?
Yeah. Yes, I think so.
Fuck, I kind of regret doing that now. Already.
Shit. Did I freak out on you? I'm sorry, Alex. I'm... not sure what came over me.
Are you sure you're okay?
Yes, I think so. Just maybe I blacked out for a minute. I guess that's what happens when you don't sleep.
Huh.
I wrecked my sculpture. It seems so crazy in here, but I feel... How do I feel?
I think I just fucked up her emotional, like, spectrum right now.
Hey, go home. You're exhausted. I'm serious. It's okay. I'll see you tonight.
I think that is the one decision that I have regretted so far this entire time. I haven't regretted anything I've done up until now, because I knew, well, I was more worried about me, myself. I didn't think there would be anything good coming from that, but.
Okay. Hear me out.
Is Typhon run by the Illuminati?
That would explain the conspicuously triangle-shaped logo.
Boom! Finally cracked it.
Hey.
Alex. So, how did things go with Charlotte?
It's kind of private.
Honestly, I think she'd want me to keep what happened just between us. Sorry.
Of course. Don't apologize.
So please tell me that the USB stick revealed all of Typhon's secrets.
Not yet, but Alex.
We found a recording of Gabe's call.
No, was I fucking right?
I should probably listen to that.
No. Come on. Don't do this to me. Don't fuck me like this. Come on.
I need to know.
We're here for you. Okay?
Oh my fucking god, I'm not ready for this. The LARP was amazing, really. You are a badass. I'm really sorry about that. Hey, Alex, it's Ethan. You don't have to apologize. I had so much fun with you. Have a great time with your dad and stay safe. Riley said, anyway, I'll be at the shop if you need anything. I really appreciate it. And then Ducky, dear Alex, what a marvelous event. Oh, I've already seen those, I think. God, I really don't want to do this. Fuck it, let's see.
Typhon safety. Mac, it's me. Fuck off, Jen. Yeah, okay, just listen. I need you to call off the explosion. Ethan's in the blast radius. Shit. He could get killed. What the hell's wrong with you? He snuck off. We're up here right now trying to find him. Mac, please.
All right. I'm on it. We'll halt the blasts. Fuck. You can't imagine the headaches this will create for me.
Thanks, Mac.
Whatever. Just doing my job.
They just ignored him. It's so fucked.
Wait.
You know it's bad when Mac turns out to be the good guy.
Okay, but this is not the...
Alex. You okay?
We're gonna get him. I promise.
What the hell?
Oh, it doesn't matter. None of it fucking matters! He's dead! He's...
Oh, shit.
Fuck that. I don't need to take this.
I should follow her. We'll be right downstairs, all right?
I knew taking her anger was a bad idea. But realistically, none of that was any different from what we already had beforehand. I feel like that anger's still inside of us.
All that matters is taking these fuckers down.
This USB stick has what I need. Time to dig through it. If that happened to me, what's happening to Charlotte?
Okay, so I have a theory. I think Charlotte is devoid of emotion now because she took a little more than just the anger out. I think she took a lot of her, like, feelings in general out. However, I think that amplified everything that I will feel. So if I feel even a tad bit of anger, I'm overboiled. If I feel a tad bit of sad, I'm fucking depressed. I have a feeling that's what happened.
A key part of any good investigation.
I fucking regret that decision. Down from his station.
Hope it comes in handy.
But I was hoping that Charlotte would be safe and Ethan would be safe too. God damn it.
A cold case and a warm beer. Thanks for spilling your guts. This time, I don't think Gabe would mind his little sister messing with his stuff. Gabe's call came in from the sat phone at 8:41 p.m. I should find the next call and see if that has any information.
Find out what happens after Gabe's call at 8:41 p.m. 8:41, so this would be...
Lena, it's Diane. We have a problem.
You're kidding.
There's a kid lost in the mountains near the pit. We need to postpone. Lena?
Haven is your site, Diane, and therefore this is your decision. I know I don't need to remind you of the stakes.
Someone could be hurt. Or killed.
We've been over this. Anyone up there has disregarded posted notices and accepted full liability.
We're talking about a child. I'm just asking for one day.
If you postpone tonight's scheduled blast, you put Rhea in jeopardy. That puts the whole company in jeopardy. Is that what you want?
No.
Then do the math and make the right call. Email me when it's done.
I will.
So Typhon thought Rhea, whatever that is, was worth risking our lives. Let's hope Diane's email sheds more light.
Where's Rhea?
This is the email Diane mentioned. So what is Rhea?
I warned you, Lena. I fucking warned you. Rhea went off undetected as you insisted, and now someone is dead. You better have a plan. I am not going down for this. At least not alone. Okay, I understand that you're upset and emotional about tonight's tragic, unavoidable accident. Therefore, I am choosing to overlook the momentary lapse of judgment.
Rhea went off undetected. A second blast went off that night? What did Lena say? Without the scheduled blast, Rhea will be discovered. It was a diversion.
They set off the blast that killed Gabe to cover up another one somewhere else. That's why they couldn't wait.
But what the fuck was that blast?
I can find out where that blast went off. It might tell me why it was so important.
So where was the second blast?
Lena. Hello, Diane. Is it safe to assume you've gotten your emotions under control?
My emotions? Someone was killed last night because of a decision you made.
I would be very careful with what you say next. Who do you think is more at risk here? Me or you?
Excuse me?
Now, of course, we're all committed to helping you make it through this difficult period. We don't want to see anyone be scapegoated over an unavoidable accident, right?
Right.
Great. Then you and I are aligned. Who else knew there were people in the mountains?
Just my safety manager, Mac. He got their distress call just before I contacted you.
Do you trust him?
I think I can convince him to be trustworthy.
Good. Good. Only one point of contact, and you've got him handled. I think we're going to make it through this just fine. Speak to you soon.
Okay.
I refuse to feel bad for Diane in all this, but
Damn.
She didn't really have a choice, but at the same time...
This is about Rhea. But it doesn't tell me where it was. That's exactly the same time the blast that killed Gabe went off.
2132. So 932. I'm confused.
Damn. Is this what Diane sold her soul for?
After our recent conversation, I took the liberty of expediting your application to the executive training program, and we will be enrolling your informant in the situation in Haven all wrapped up.
Who would have thought getting away with murder would be so bureaucratic?
Oh shit, what the fuck? Okay, that's not what I meant to do.
H&B Investigations. Bennett speaking.
Hi, Bennett. This is Diane Jacobs. Lena told me...
Yep. Been expecting your call.
Okay. I'm not sure what the next step is.
Just need all the pertinent information on the employee in question. Name, number, address, significant others. We'll handle the rest.
I see.
Just come by the office. My secretary will take everything down. No records that you were even there.
Got it. Okay. I'll come by tomorrow.
Looking forward to it.
It's so gross that Typhon has people watched.
Where was the second blast? I don't get where...
Diane has dossiers on the entire Haven Council. That's not creepy at all.
Jesus fucking Christ, that is insane.
This is Rhea! Fuck. This map's too small to tell where this is.
I need a map.
Boom.
That's the site of the 2008 Typhon mine collapse. Why would they set off a blast in their current mine to cover up a blast in their old mine? Didn't Typhon just have inspections around the old site? They weren't mining for anything. They were burying something.
Hmm. All right, Alex chose Steph to distract Diane, 61%. Makes sense. Alex took Charlotte's anger from her, 54%. Wow, okay, so a lot more people did that. I still regret the decision, though. I should have just left her. Alex made Diane sad. Alex didn't play a record, 30%. Alex did some leading on the rooftop, 52%. Ethan and Alex were never knocked out in battle, 98%. Yeah, it's pretty easy, I think, personally, but whatever. The troll was killed in battle, 49%. The serpent was put to sleep, 59%. Steph stormed out of the apartment, 54%. King Tabor was vanquished in the final battle. Nobody... Wow. So, everybody destroyed King Tabor. That makes sense. Riley doesn't know about Eleanor's condition, 100%. I don't know. Was I supposed to do something about that? Hmm. Alex didn't play the song stuck in the student's head, 34%. Yeah, I didn't know how to fix that. Alex and Ethan didn't solve the Jester's riddle. Oh. We're probably supposed to go back to him, but... Oh, well. Alex and Ethan helped the blacksmith with his work. Yes. Okay. Chapter 4. Flicker. Just wow, man.
Pike, it's all on this USB drive. All the evidence you need to nail Typhon for Gabe's death and plenty more.
All right.
Is she wearing a skirt or shorts?
I'll meet you in an hour.
Thanks.
I was scared Pike was like a piece of shit.
Citizens of Haven Springs, we are live at the Spring Festival. One final reminder to head over to the Lathe Flower Cart and grab a rose before they're gone.
At Haven's inaugural spring festival, eligible women of stock and birthing age would offer up roses in order to attract a mate. What can I say? History is weird. Thankfully, we've lost the mating stuff, but kept the roses. And if you do have a special someone in mind, a rose is a great way to say you care. And an even better way to say, hey look, a rose.
Sounds fun. Is giving away a rose something I'd do? Maybe. I can decide downstairs. For now, I'll grab the USB stick.
Jesus Christ, Alex, you're looking good. Ethan, okay,
Just dropped a block of alabaster. On purpose. Because I wouldn't stop digging.
So officially be returning to normal hours operation. Thank you for your loyal customers. Come see us on post-burying festival vibes. Nice, about time. Good for you, Charlotte. Best news I've heard all week.
Guess the festival started a while ago.
Spring festival has begun. First up, we have an annual chili cook-off, and later we'll have live music. A chili cook-off sounds incredible. I would love that. Woohoo, finally, chili, beer, and jelly beans, the ingredient for another great festival. Jed, you the man. Thanks everyone for an excellent spring chili cook-off. My mouth is still burning. Killer chili, Mike. Remind me to get that recipe for the lantern. You wish. I am so full.
Steph did a really great job putting all that together.
Yeah, I had a blast. Me too. We should do it again. Splendid work, Stephanie. Is that what that was? Still banned. Kind Haven listeners, we are now live at the Spring Festival. Swing by our trailer in the park to grab some raffle tickets and maybe win some merch. Okay.
Looks like the festival is already in full swing. I'm pretty nervous. Pretty, but not very Gabe. Why does he have this?
Traditionally, you give roses to your crush at the spring festival, so...
I've never had a girl give me flowers before.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you cared so much about traditional gender roles. I'll get back to my butter churning and doilies.
Shut up.
You first.
That's cute. Leaky faucet?
I've been meaning to tell Jed about the sink, but I'm afraid he'll try to teach me how to fix it myself.
Pants.
Don't worry. I'll come back to you.
Okay. Is there anything new in here, or semi-new, or not new, or what? It's the same shit. No, there's some different shit in here.
Yeah. This one ornament will really bring my tree together. Ah, string lights. The key to unlocking the Cozy Places subreddit. What are the chances your instruction manual is in here? For now, I'll grab the USB stick. I'm thinking this will make an excellent after-festival snack. Happy Spring Festival, Gabe. I remember trying to pregame as a teenager and just going to sleep instead. I think I'll stick with Minesweeper from now on.
Did I grab it? Do I have it or what? Son of lead.
Man, the latest issue gets dark.
Dude, that shit looks
so
sick.
I'm sure Ethan will be fine.
I want some of that now.
I've been playing more these past few weeks in the last few years. Feels nice.
Okay, there we go.
I'm about ready to start my own list.
Donate to Lawrence Detention Center, a new bong for Kevin, apologize to Zoe. She moved to Maryland, check it out. Okay, can I... Shoo-shoo.
Will you be my date to the festival, Shoo-shoo?
Letter.
The world really doesn't deserve Thaynor.
Alex, don't worry about me. The drive down south with my dad always makes me feel better, and we have lots of plans for the summer. He said we could go camping and make ultra s'mores but with ice cream on top. Secret family recipe. LARP was amazing. You are a really good bard, and I hope we can do it again soon. I already have more ideas to fill out your backstory. Banshees. Thanks, Alex, Ethan. Cute. Bard at?
Alwyn the Bard will ride again.
Can I go upstairs?
The USB stick is on my desk.
No, I can't. Okay. That sucks balls, but okay, cool. Well, I don't want to grab that yet because I'm pretty sure that advances dialogue. So, let's see if I can change this. Which I'm pretty sure I can, but... Okay, it doesn't look too bad. It's not bad. Jane Doe, I like it. I'm gonna be honest. I like the original one. The original one is probably the best, in my personal opinion.
I've got a lot riding on you. Small, inanimate object.
Alex, you are...
Okay.
Too much.
Time to head downstairs.
Eleanor. Are you... Alex, I'm so sorry about before. I really did appreciate your help. Don't apologize. It's been hard for all of us. Are you joining us this evening, dear? Yes, this is one party I'm willing to brave. We'll make it as painless as possible. Anything from my block? No? Okay. Then I'll just go fuck myself instead. Alright, let's go.
You own a skirt?
Hey, guys.
Happy first Spring Fest.
Thanks. I need to apologize to you guys. What happened in the apartment? Something really messed me up.
Helping Charlotte, yeah.
These past few weeks, I thought I had a handle on my emotions. But after what happened with Charlotte, it's the same old story. I lose control, and I hurt the people I care about. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Fuck that. If anyone needs to apologize, it's me. Ever since we've met, you've been there for me. And then when you're the one struggling, I bail. Not cool. I'm really sorry.
It's totally fine. But I still owe you a new trophy.
Yeah,
let's play for it.
Oh, fuck, here we go.
Not to spoil the moment, but Typhon blew up their own mine. Why?
I don't know yet. But we have all the evidence we need to nail them for Gabe's death. I got a hold of Pike. He'll be here soon. Once he sees what's on that stick, it's over for Typhon.
Hence the celebration. I think we've all earned the right to enjoy ourselves a little tonight.
The band's coming on soon. You'd better be front and center.
He's playing, yeah.
Nice. Who's playing?
Local band. You'll love them.
I have to run back to the trailer. Go be a normal person for a while.
Can't make any promises. Text me when it's ready.
Okay, let's go enjoy ourselves.
If I wanted to give away a rose, Steph and Ryan would definitely be on my list.
Steph.
Anyway, time to enjoy the festival.
Happy Spring Festival. Thanks for celebrating. no spoilers, but Thaner finds a gate to the underworld and fights the King of Demons. Oh, snap. That actually seems like a pretty big spoiler. That's the first page, Ilola. They're trying to hide something. Holy shit, Steph and I want to hear everything. We're at the stage. Meet us when you're ready.
Maybe I could give two-faced Diane. Bitch.
Hi, Alex. Wanted to wish you a wonderful first spring festival. Unfortunately, I have to work through it this year. But I really appreciate our conversation earlier today. It was great getting to know you better. Thanks, Diane. The feeling is mutual. Sure. Take one for someone special. Limited supply.
I've never seen anyone so focused on a jelly bean jar. Hi.
Oh, hey. Nice to see you.
You're taking this jelly bean thing very seriously.
Yeah, because the prize is a $100 gift card. That's my mom fair. Just got a promotion, so I thought I could take her out for a nice dinner. Which is really embarrassing, saying it out loud.
Not at all. That's sweet. Maybe I can help.
Oh, for real? Are you good at this? How many jelly beans do you think there are?
I don't want to fucking fuck this guy over. Yeah, go 300. It doesn't look like
300 ish.
Huh. Yeah, could be.
Feels like something just changed in that lady by the jar. Maybe I should read her.
This game is so demoralizing. Why do I do this to myself?
Maybe I can help him. This is impossible, right? She's definitely hiding something behind that smile.
What fucking smile?
300? What a nitwit. Not even close.
I was that far off? Maybe I should say something before he guesses wrong. Also, hey, I've got another guess.
Yeah?
700.
I think it's closer to 700.
Yeah. 700 feels right. But we have to get it exactly.
Just felt that lady's heart skip a beat. I should read her again.
Dear me, they're really close to 731. Who is this girl?
Hell yes! Your secret's mine.
Don't say it like in front of the guy.
The answer is 731. Don't ask me how.
731 jelly beans.
That's correct.
Yes! Thanks so much for your help. You rule.
No sweat.
Like, can I, look
I
this
don't think
of
this thing
beer?
Is checking IDs. Nobody tell Pike.
The Jelly Bean Guessing Contest is ending. Congratulations to our winner, Hector Gonzalez. Oh, that's Hector Gonzalez. Cool. Thank you. Hold the applause. Crap, I thought it was going until midnight. Normally, yes, but we had a perfect guess. No way, someone actually won this time? Yeah, I'm surprised. It's been, what, 4 years? I think 5. Diorama. It's a nice little town.
Wow. This is a beautiful model.
It is.
It happened last year. Yep. I remember it clear as day.
It's been a hell of a month. But this makes it all worthwhile.
Jed loves this town so much. It's inspiring. It's nice to see Jed so in his element.
Jed's like that dad, that white dad that
I love. Radio station broadcast life.
Black Beast of P. Audley's Traveling Circus. Okay.
Oh, hi, Val.
They even looped you into participating, huh?
Yeah, you are evil. I will be honest.
This is awesome. Favorite time of the year, by far.
That kind of enthusiasm is infectious, especially for me. Especially for me. What, no marshmallows? Come on.
Just gonna relax, Alex.
So this is that whole communal gathering thing everyone's always going on about. I guess Riley is feeling sentimental tonight, but I haven't seen her around. Where is she?
It's like this always reminds me of how lucky I am with all this place one, no other place will ever come close. Ryan puts my face, you're not so bad yourself. It's cute. It's like we're getting down to our last baskets of roses. If you haven't given one, you're special someone she got to love.
Oh, Mr. Lantern. I love what you've done with your bar.
So then, where's the after party this year?
Eleanor after must be relieved party. That the festival
Come
is
on.
Finally here.
Young man like yourself, you must know what the haps is.
God.
Honestly, I'm
I
getting
just
pretty
hope Riley
pushed.
Is doing all right.
I'm calling it a night
oh, no.
soon.
What happened
My
to Riley?
Goodness. What is this town?
Hi, Eleanor.
Good evening, dear.
Hey, so where's Riley? I haven't seen her around.
Well, she's got a lot going on right now. I think she'd rather keep to herself tonight.
Okay. That was odd. I wonder if there's something she's not telling me. Decorations really turned out beautifully. It must have been a huge amount of work.
It's worth it.
So, we doing shots tonight or what?
Of course. Body shots. Who's going first? Just kidding. Or am I?
I better get going.
That was a perfect one to end on. Ryan, everything's set. Meet me at the stage on my way instead.
Sounds like Ryan is ready for me. You too. My bad.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoy your night.
There's no graceful way to sample everything on this table. Is there? The world's most unnecessary vodka delivery system. Steph is just awesome. Maybe I could give a rose to her. Hey, Steph!
You already know. You already know what's happening.
This is for you.
Are you serious?
Of course I am.
Dude, thank you so much. This totally makes my night.
I'm glad.
Hey, could we meet up after the show tonight? I actually have some pretty big news to share. She said mysteriously.
Of course.
Speaking of, Ryan should be done any minute. Meet me there?
Yeah.
Sure.
This whole fucking game is just...
Doing this takes a certain type of person, and I am not that person.
This game just like, I don't know, I love this game. This is game of the year for me, definitely.
I don't think Ryan can go a day in his life without being helpful to someone. Hey!
Oh, hey. Just in time.
So, who's playing?
Yours truly.
Seriously? That's awesome! Well, wait, who else? Steph. Who else is playing? I hate you both.
We didn't want you to wuss out.
Yeah, absolutely would have wussed.
Wussing out is highly underrated. We haven't even practiced yet.
Who cares? Everyone's wasted anyway. Just play whatever. I'll follow your lead. This is gonna be awesome. Trust me.
We've never played together before, and...
Stop being so scared. Live in the moment, Alex.
Anyway.
Fuck. Come on.
Sorry if this sucks. Fuck it.
Feels, man. I'm feeling it. Oh. Charlotte is so weird. Dude, I'm telling you, she's like devoid of emotion. It's fucking scary. Now it's even scarier than what it was beforehand.
Hey, Charlotte. How deep do you think? The lake, I mean. I don't know. I felt horrible this afternoon. I didn't know if I could survive that feeling. But now... It's like when your leg falls asleep. And even though it's still attached, it's become something other than you. My whole life, I've always felt so deeply. But Maybe this
I was
is
right.
better?
She's devoid of emotion. She's just not really there. I'm sorry.
Charlotte, I'm so sorry. Sorry for what? I didn't mean for any of this to happen. Me neither. Good to see you, Alex. Have fun at the festival.
God, I fucking already regret that decision. Totally, entirely, I regret it. Oh, I fucking regret it so bad. Hey, come meet me on the rooftop. Sure thing. Steph? Gotta chill out. Is it live music time? Kind of Haven listeners. So start making your way to the stage and make sure you're in a good spot. Sick, yes.
Okay. I gotta admit, this is a pretty great feeling.
Something else, Steph. Alex, bravo. Wow. Thanks, guys. We had a blast. Totally starstruck.
Sounds like Steph wants to meet me on the rooftop.
But do I want to meet her on the rooftop? Yeah. Alex and Steph need to be a thing.
Ugh. Not tonight.
Right? Oh god, there's so much here. Oh, am I gonna pick what I can take up there?
What about acute emotional kleptomania? Odds are pretty good. I'm grabbing a cup later tonight. Jed bought this as a treat for the regulars. And himself, I'm guessing. It was so fun watching Jed play the villain. What a good sport.
Okay. Let's go. Glad this episode so far has been very lighthearted. Well, besides Charlotte.
Said you have some news?
I'm leaving. I'm actually leaving Haven Springs. Can you believe it? Back on the road again. Fucking finally.
Wait, seriously?
I'm gonna play music again, Alex. Anywhere I want. God, I forgot how fucking good it feels.
This sucks.
I don't know what to say. I want to be supportive, but...
Hey, come on. No time to be sad. We've got work to do. I need a new destination. You're my good luck charm.
You have shit taste in good luck charms.
Shut up. Pick one.
Salem, Berlin, or the ocean? These are really the choices you picked? Fuck it, go to Salem, I guess.
Salem? Halloween capital of the world. Or so they say. Who do I hang out with?
Massholes.
What if you infiltrate a group of Massachusetts bros? Hang out in a dank bar until 2, shouting, "Go Sox!" at the TV?
You know what? Yeah, that sounds wicked rad. Get real tough and edgy. Really integrate into the whole scene.
You start challenging dudes twice your size to drinking contests. You never lose, obviously. That sounds like a pretty spectacular plan.
Great. Then come with me.
What? To Salem?
Sure, why not? Doesn't have to be our first stop, but one day. I still have friends in Seattle who book shows. Maybe we start there, or I don't know, Kansas City, Vegas,
Kansas City,
wherever we want.
Hey, Steph, all right.
Look, I don't want to pressure you, but I've seen you give so much of yourself to make sure other people get what they need. And I guess I wonder if you've thought about what you need. I mean, obviously, I like you a lot, Alex. You mean the fucking world to me.
Kiss, do it.
Kiss me. Kiss me. Kiss me. Kiss me.
Sweet. Finally, I'm glad they're a fucking thing now, finally. Jesus fucking Christ. Sweet.
You don't have to decide anything now, okay? Just think about it.
I will. Thank you.
Okay, if we definitely get the choice, yeah, we're doing it.
I'm gonna head back down. Find me later.
But I didn't see Pike, and I didn't give him the flash drive.
Hey, Gabe. Can I tell you something? I think I solved it. Why you died? Who's responsible? Isn't that crazy? I'm out of threads to pull, which is terrifying. Because on the other side of all this, after Typhon, after you, there's just normal life.
Yeah.
I was kind of counting on you to show me how to do that. But I think I can figure it out. I just wish you were here to see it. Also, I kissed Steph, so that happened.
At some point, this is gonna make me cry, and I'm having a feeling it's probably gonna be on the last one. Like, I've gotten close quite a bit of times here, so... Oh yeah, I could leave. I kind of forgot that. Don't... Fuck. Thought she was gonna throw it or some shit. That's what I thought she was gonna do the first time. Sorry, I may have stayed a little too long, but I forgot that I could just leave, so...
Alex. Do you have the USB drive?
I do. It's all here. Gabe's call, their secret plan, the cover-up.
You need to come with me to the station. Alex? Don't make this hard.
I knew this son of a bitch was crooked. I fucking knew it. I guess it could be arresting me because I stole the USB technically.
Probably isn't how you pictured your first spring festival, huh?
Not exactly.
Coffee?
How about a beer?
How about a beer? Worth a shot. Pike, why am I here?
The long and short of it is, Diane is charging you with stealing her USB drive.
Yeah, what?
What the hell are you talking about?
Did you steal this USB drive or not?
At least tell me you looked at it.
I can't. Sorry.
Why not?
What do you mean? Why not?
Well, one, I would need a warrant. And two, the case is closed. The order came down today. I did what I could, but, you know, evidence just wasn't there. Sorry, Alex.
The order came down today from who?
High up. Boss's boss's boss. It's not my job to know.
Look, what happened to my brother wasn't an accident. It was criminal. The files on that drive prove it.
That could be true. Let's say it is. The issue is, you stole Typhon's property. I can't work with that.
Shouldn't matter.
I just handed you a smoking gun. It shouldn't matter how I got it.
Maybe not, but it does. Alex, you're not thinking about this clearly.
Seems pretty clear to me.
Diane wants to charge you with computer fraud. That's a federal crime, Alex. 5 to 10, easy.
Fuck Diane.
You know what? Fuck Diane. This isn't justice. This is a joke.
It's not that bad. Hey, I talked to her, and despite how angry she is at everything you did, she's willing to let it go.
Oh, what the fuck? For what?
If you agree to drop everything, Typhon won't press any charges.
This is fucking funny. Yeah, right?
She's only offering that deal because she knows I have her. She's guilty, Pike.
Right, if the case is closed.
Even if you're right, your only evidence is inadmissible. I think you should do it.
Fuck that. I'm not signing anything.
Thank you, Alex.
Alex.
No. Typhon buried something in the mountains. Something so massive, they ignored Gabe's call and set off the blast just to cover it up. Don't you want to know what it is?
What do you mean, cover it up?
Another blast, unannounced, set off at the exact same time at the old mining site. And all of it happened just a few weeks before inspections were set to begin. Come on, Pike. It's all right here.
Like I said, it doesn't matter. Alex, please, just sign the form, and we can both go back to the party.
No.
Alex, this is not an offer that you can choose.
I said no.
No, it's not an option.
What are you so scared of?
See for yourself.
Shit. What could be in that envelope? A deal. Just like they offered Charlotte. Fuck me. Pike's really shaken.
Alex, please. I don't want you to get hurt.
Then help me, damn it.
Typhon Mining Security Threat Evaluation, Shin Alexandria, Anti-Typhon Sentiment. Brother Gabriel Chin died on accident or related incident. Until such subject has high level of determination and efficiency. Negative affection has persisted beyond predicted bereavement period. Suspect also appears to have possession of confidential data and information. Alexandra Chin, Threat Assessment, 5-1 to 5-25, 2019. Began following subject meeting with Mac Loudon. Subject met with identified as Ryan Lucan. Little else of note. 5-13 subject spent 3 hours in apartment. Wi-Fi screen monitoring revealed searches in the Typhon's history and legal litigation records. Subject met and spoke with client in Black Lantern, and subject stolen from an object from client. Ryan Lucan, close friend Gabriel Chin, died in an accident. Assisting Alexandra Chin with her efforts against Typhon, involved in extremely distraught over accident. Subject has high level knowledge of both geography and residents of Haven. Stephanie Gingrich, close friend Gabriel Chin, died in an accident. Assisting Alexandra Chin in her efforts has proven resourceful and dangerous.
Is this a threat?
What did you expect? Huh? The Typhon, a global organization with billions in revenue, an army of lawyers, and who knows how many politicians in their pockets would just throw up their hands and say, "You got us."
I thought I could get justice for Gabe.
Yeah, well, Typhon has their own idea of justice.
Shit.
Believe me, I want nothing more than to make these fuckers pay. I've learned the hard way that it's not possible. They're too big. Too connected, too ruthless.
I spoke too soon when I said that this was all going as planned and happy. And
you can hate me if you want. Call me a coward. But I don't want to lose you like we lost Gabe.
Pike is terrified of Typhon. I bet if I took his fear away. But it's not just about me. Steph and Ryan are in danger too. I want to hurt Typhon so bad, but can I really put their lives at risk along with mine?
I don't want to pick. I really don't. Fuck. We've seen what happened last time when we took Charlotte's anger. You can't do that to anybody else.
All I have to do is sign?
Yeah. X marks the spot.
Can't turn back now. Time to sign my soul away.
I thought he was crooked, but he's not.
Thank you, Alex. You did the right thing.
Let's see when you get the chance, Jeff.
I can't believe this. I had them. How did it go so wrong? I have no idea what to do next. Maybe talking to Jed will help me feel better. First, I need to get out of this dress. Might as well go talk to Jed now.
Nabby, let me see what we got.
I look better than I feel.
Damn, okay.
Hey, Jed.
There she is. Have a seat. Something tells me you've had a more exciting spring festival than you planned for.
You saw Pike arrest me.
And let you go, apparently. Then there's that business with Ryan and Steph earlier today. I wasn't sure why it took all three of you to work out Diane's lunch order. I know you're used to looking out for yourself. Gabe was like that. But Haven's a community. We help each other. I want to help you. But first, you have to let me know what's going on.
Fuck it. What have I got to lose?
Take a shot, yeah.
Typhon killed Gabe. I have proof.
What proof?
I stole it from Diane. Emails and documents proving there was a second explosion the night Gabe died. To cover something up, Jed. Some secret they buried. I don't know what it is. I don't even know what to do next. But I'm not giving up. Not ever.
Alex, you already have. Sorry.
I know what they're hiding.
What is it?
Please, Jed. What's the truth? What are they afraid of?
Typhon's the devil that runs this town. I've been carrying their secrets for far too long. Fuck, I know what Jed. They buried in the mountains.
Tell me.
I'll do one better. I'll show you.
Did you?
There, up ahead.
Where are we?
Middle of nowhere. About 2 clicks that way is the mining site where you search for Ethan. 5 clicks that way is town.
What is this thing?
Ventilation shaft. They're scattered everywhere. Over the years, mines grow into mines, creating a labyrinth under Haven. What you're searching for is down below.
Jed, why are you sad?
I thought he was going to do something.
I'm sorry, kid.
What's happening?
Jed, what are you doing?
I tried to talk you out of it, scare you off. I was sure those pictures of Ryan and Steph would do the trick. But you were relentless. Won't leave damn well enough alone.
You don't have to do this.
I do. 12 years ago, I made a mistake. The kind of thing that you can't undo.
He was the reason for the fucking thing.
The Typhon made me a deal. A way to save my town. Give my boy a normal life. I never wanted Gabe to get hurt.
Go to hell.
Don't you fucking dare tell me this is the end. Oh my god, I was about to fucking flip shit. Pike convinced Alex to sign Typhon's affidavit. Wow. A lot of people picked to let go over fear. Sorry, I can't do that shit. Alex gave Rose to Steph. Alex had a nice moment by the bonfire. Alex didn't sit on the couch. Steph and Alex mused about moving to Salem. Steph and Alex shared a kiss. Ryan didn't meet Alex on the rooftop. 72%. Wow. Okay, and then Ryan didn't meet Alex on the rooftop, 72%. Charlotte felt weirdly detached at the festival. Alex didn't find Riley at the bus stop. Alex didn't use her power with Ducky. Oh, I didn't even know where the fuck Ducky was. Alex helped the jelly bean counter win the contest. Alex didn't talk to the diner buyer. And Alex didn't help them admit their feelings. Chapter 5, Side B.
Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
What the fuck is going on? The meaning of home?
I thought I learned what it means to make a place your home. That must have felt like quite the victory. Let's talk about how it feels to know that you might have been wrong. I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a pretty girl. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
I know. But what the fuck is this?
Oh, you don't know anything, Alex. You don't even know you're not really here.
What is happening right now?
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Is that what I look like? Really? Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
I'm very confused right now.
I guess that's me. Case number 53322. I guess that's me. Case number 53322.
Alexandra Alex Chen, 21, female. Symptoms: emotional instability, occasional violent outbursts, hallucinations, visual hallucinations, oral, delusional ideation, depression, anxiety, diagnosis unknown.
Thrown down a... what?
Alex experiences a detailed, robust delusion that she is able to read other people's emotional states and believes that because of this ability, she is uniquely equipped to help others overcome their own emotional trauma. It's difficult to overlook the irony someone as profoundly dysfunctional as Alex adopting the role of emotional caretaker. Had she not been returned to my care, I do not think it hyperbolic to speculate that her reckless attempts at fixing her friends and family would eventually have gotten someone hurt. It's my belief that Alex's delusions constitute a threat to her continued well-being as well as those of others. As such, I recommend Alex be thrown down an endless pit, her body shattered against each jutting board and errant brick until she's forgotten at the darkest beneath the world. this is, in my professional opinion, the most humane thing to do for her. What the fuck is happening?
Dr. Lin always records our sessions. These don't belong to Dr. Lin. A tuning peg.
Dr. Lin, in light of all the recent excitement, now's a good time to remind Helping Hands residents that impulses to leave our institution, while understandable, are best resisted. Remember, the outside world is sharp-toothed and possessive and insatiable hunger, and you are soft and slow and appetizing. Why throw yourself into its mouth? Throw yourself instead into mine.
How did I even get back here? Alex Chen? My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure.
I don't think this will actually let me out. Let me see.
I've got to get out of this place.
Yeah,
of course. I guess that's me. Case number 53322. Gabe gave me this guitar, but he never heard me play it.
Mm-hmm. doors are. Shit.
Alex.
Gabe? You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, but why?
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me.
Alright, I really fucking hate to do this, but I'm gonna have to stop it here. This is fucking going crazy, but if you guys enjoyed, like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell, all that good stuff. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.